In this moment, O God, we turn to you. May the ebb and flow of our thinking settle into stillness. May each heaviness we carry be released into your love. May the cycles of our breathing restore a spaciousness within. May we listen gently enough to touch the hem of your presence. Lord, it is night. The night is for stillness. Let us be still in the presence of God.
Good evening and welcome to our service of Taize. In the quiet of this night, we seek your presence, O God. May our souls be alive to your nearness. Amidst the tiredness that pervades our activities, the tensions that linger in our minds, the loneliness that disturbs our peace, and the fears and uncertainties that skulk in the shadows of our hearts, may we know your presence, O God. May our souls be alive to your nearness.
Holy Spirit, come.
Our psalm is Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he that made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations.
A reading from Paul's epistle to the Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you.
A reading from the book of John. When they found Jesus on the other side of the sea, they said to him, Rabbi, when did you come here? Jesus answered them, Very truly I tell you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For it is on him that God the Father has set his seal. Then they said to him, What must we do to perform the works of God? Jesus answered them, This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent. So they said to him, What sign are you going to give us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What work are you performing? Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, and it is written, He gave them bread from heaven to eat. Then Jesus said to them, Very truly I tell you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. They said to him, Sir, give us this bread always. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. And whoever believes in me shall never be thirsty. The word of the Lord.
I will ring us into a few minutes of silence.
Let us pray. Holy God, maker of heaven and earth, you created all people in your image. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred which infect our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love and work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purposes on earth, that in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Gracious God in Christ, you have ordered us to live as loving neighbors. Though we are scattered in different places, speak different languages, or come from different ethnic backgrounds, give us common concern so that we may be one people who share the governing of the world. May greed, war, and lust for power be curbed, and all people enter community of love that you have promised. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Sovereign God, your will to rule the ways of peoples and reign over every earthly government. Work with those who work for peace. Make every person in authority an agent of your reconciliation, and every diplomat an ambassador of hope. Give all the leaders of the world the wisdom and strength to know your will and to do it, that through your spirit we may finally see peace and goodwill among all people. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Loving God, be with all who are engaged in wars of any kind. Strengthen them in their trials and temptations. Give them courage to face the perils which beset them, and grant them a sense of your abiding presence wherever they may be. Give them compassion for their enemies. Keep them from a hate that hardens, or from a score keeping with human lives. When they must be at war, let them live for peace, as eager for agreement as for victory. Comfort loved ones who await their return. Give them patience, wisdom, and hope in these uncertain times, and increase their faith and assurance in your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Eternal God, in your perfect realm, no sword is drawn but the sword of right relationships, and there is no strength but the strength of love. So mightily spread abroad your spirit, that all peoples may be gathered as your children under the banner of the Prince of Peace. Lord, in your mercy,
Hear our prayer.
Open our hearts to your power moving around us, between us and within us, until your presence is revealed in our love of both friend and enemy, in communities transformed by just and compassion, and in the healing of all that is broken. Amen.
Bless the Lord, my soul, and bless God's holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul, who leads me into life. Bless the Lord, my soul, and bless God's holy name. Bless God. my soul, oh, leads me into life.
Let us pray in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Oh,
In the quiet of the night, may we know your presence, O God. At the ending of the day, may our souls be alive to your nearness. Amidst the tiredness that overcomes our bodies and the tensions that linger in our minds, amidst the uncertainties and fears that haunt our hearts. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.
No.